Hello everyone, this is Aku Chi, back with some more Dominion. This is my World Cup match against Marin from France. I am the last hope for America. Unfortunately, our brethren, USA A team, was defeated by Japan in this quarterfinals round. And we are currently down 2.5 to 1.5. In the set against, or no, that doesn't seem right. 2-1 in the set against France. So I need to win. Not only do I need to win with 4.5 games to win a clean victory, and 4 games to get into a sudden death situation. So, a flawless victory is the plan. I've got America on my shoulders. I don't plan to let her down. So captain looks pretty great here. Can play as steward and pixie and ironworks and sacrifice. All good things. Unfortunately, we do have a 5-2 with goat in our 5 hand. On the one hand, that's not too bad because we can just open a 2 cost next turn. Is there any 5 that's good to open? I wouldn't mind having a Haunted Woods. But trashing a copper and getting a steward also seems pretty great. So let's do that. All right, Marin goes first in game one. We have a pretty bad start, but hopefully we can persevere. See, Luna plus by is Sacred Grove, which Captain cannot play as. Devil's Workshop is something to consider. Certainly don't dislike Imp. I really hope I draw an estate here. I guess if I don't draw an estate, it means I'll be able to trash 2 estates next turn, which is pretty good. Alright. Well, I think we're going to keep that. Now we might consider not trashing a copper. Maybe we just want to get started with Sacred Grove. Or we could get a Caravan or Delve Pixie. The Caravan's not too great. Like, if we have the captain for some duration draw. Yeah, I just think trashing is gonna be pretty good. So I think I like Silver Pixie here. Silver's going to be our way to get to Captain and Sacred Grove and such. Yeah, trashing Pixie would have been reasonable there. Seems like the kind of board where you can do quite a lot with overdraw. Well, the plus actions situation is pretty rough. So this could be a captain here. Yeah, I think I'd rather get a captain than a Sacred Grove and trash copper. It's pretty close. Captain does get quite a bit worse if Pixie's empty, which, they could. Okay, so you got the Seize Gift to get that. Yeah, I think we're gonna grab a captain here. So for plus actions, we also have like Ironwork Sacrifice stuff. So how does that look? Ironwork Sacrifice. Is card neutral? Or do we even lose a card? Yeah, I think it costs three cards. So it's basically like a Necropolis effect. So definitely not our preferred source of actions. Our preferred source of actions is Captain as Pixie. But whoever ends up with fewer captains is going to have an incentive to empty Pixies. Imp is a little bit awkward. Okay, at the end of this turn. Seems like a pretty good tempo play. And we could grab another captain here. Or we trash and gain Pixie, I guess. Yeah, we're gonna trigger a shuffle. I think I'm okay. Taking it a little slower. Yeah, I think Haunted Woods, a pair of Haunted Woods is probably going to be worth it. Both Haunted Woods and Caravan play poorly with Imp, looking at the Devil's Workshop situation. And Captain, actually. So, yeah, I think that's a no to Devil's Workshop. Captain number two, but he's a little off duration-wise right now. We're gonna trash a little more slowly. Now this could be good. Now I think we'll get a captain here. And trash a copper. I don't know, maybe what I'm doing is too slow. Oh, we can sacrifice a copper as well. Kind of comes to the same thing. All right, so we have a full draw here. Or do I have three pixies? So I think I want to play the first captain as steward for cards. The second one is ironwork for something. And we know what the remaining four cards of our deck are, right? We have a goat, we have a silver. I think we have one more pixie there. All right, so that's all the pixies. Okay. Good to know. So, does it make sense to play? No, I think we need to. Go into silver in there. I think we have a pixie and another copper, would be my guess. So we can ironwork here or do it later with our second captain. I think I prefer to do it now. In the event that, well, just trying to think about what pixie boons I could get. that would affect things. Not sure there are any. But we're pretty definitely gonna gain caravan, right? Definitely not worth Will-O-Wisp. It's definitely a pretty good card. We don't have too much that it draws. So it just kind of gives us information. Let's draw with our actual steward. Do we want the extra money? I don't think so. I think we get a Sacred Grove here. Think the plus buy is going to pay off. So he had a two captain Haunted Woods turn. Interesting. I have two pixies. I'm not sure what I'm saving them for. I guess Forest Gift or Field Gift at a good time, or like near the end of the game, maybe a Wind's Gift or a Sea's Gift or River's Gift or something. I think we'll just hold on to him for a little while. He's got a lot of cards in his deck. He just hasn't trashed nearly as many coppers as I have. He's also got more pixies. I only have two, so he's got five, four now. So maybe we need to use both of our captains this turn as Ironworks. Oh, you got the Swamp's Gift too, huh? Well, that's pretty good. Think he's done drawing. His next turn just has one duration card, which is pretty weak. He does not have plus buy. At some point, I'll sacrifice a steward from a captain. But we don't need to do that this turn. Well, caravans are still in the supply. Wow, okay. Yeah, I've never played Marin before, but he has a reputation. Old school player who used to build crazy engines when not many people did that. Oh, he's got more caravans. And we can see that here. He's going for the ironwork sacrifice thing. Cool. I don't think I have another two-cost card. Let's go ahead and play the Sacred Grove right now. That's not bad. I don't know that we can support all that payload, but we can this turn. Yeah, hopefully I don't come to regret this, but all right, let's just think about this a little more. So we'd have 4 coins with Go Trash and Copper, 6 with the silver. We could get to 8 with the steward, or we can get to 10 if we gain these silvers. What do we do with 8? What do we do with 10? With 8, we might just buy 2 caravans as a kind of denial play. We might do the same thing with 10, but also pick up another silver. Yeah, I think. I think I'm gonna take it. So we're going to split the caravans. He's got a bunch of ironworks. Two more pixies than I do. So we definitely province this turn. I think we can make do with just two buys. I'm very glad he didn't get that Earth's Gift next turn. This turn he's got no chance of piling out, but next turn, with two captains and a Haunted Woods down, it'd be very scary. And a bunch of caravans. In terms of draw, he's played. Oh, does he have a steward? Oh, he does. Maybe? Yeah, maybe there's a chance. Because he's got another captain, and he can, like, sacrifice his Haunted Woods. He's got one more pixie. Maybe he can end it this turn. Yeah. Seems tough. I'm not sure that there's. Well, I doubt that there's a guaranteed win. But there might be a chance to win here. So he's got three ironworks in hand, two caravans, a pixie. He's got the sacrifice. He can pretty easily empty ironworks to. Two. So we just need to draw two of those ironworks to be able to end it with a win. Yeah, actually, I think a win is pretty likely for Marin. Yeah, I think it's actually there. But the fact that you have to discard two silvers means you might draw them up. So the question is, does he have eight cards worth, like eight draw in his hand? I count seven that he can use. Sacrifice on Haunted Woods for two. Two caravans, one pixie. Up to five, and then a captain as steward, up to seven. So I think he has a likely win. Oh wait, and then he can ironworks for estate, maybe? So he's going for it. Interesting. I feel like if you're going for it, you take two ironworks there. Well, he is definitely not going for it. Now we each just have one pixie left. Oh, I might have been wrong, I guess, about the number of pixies that he has left, so. Oh, but he also had the steward left. Yeah, I think there was a win there. Unless I'm missing something. I think there was a win. Oh, he needed an action to play a Sacred Grove. Well, maybe. Yeah, I guess he was a little action limited. He's just, like, action limited in general here, because he's got a Haunted Woods and a Sacred Grove he wants to play. Ooh, trashing the caravan. Okay, that's not double province, thankfully. Next turn will be very strong for Marin. Okay. I think we sacrifice. The steward, probably. Or maybe we ironworks for a sacrifice? Yeah, let's do that. All right, Will-O-Wisps. Oh, that was nice. Guess we Sacred Grove here. I don't think we want to... Well, can play it on goat. Oh. Yeah, I'm action limited as well. Do we just get province duchy? No, we probably go with province Sacred Grove as well. I feel like Marin's got a pretty good chance to win if I do that. The province duchy does not leave me in a very good spot. But where there's a will, there's a way, perhaps. Yeah, I think I need to go for points. Now the question is, do I keep the goat or not? How do I hit double province? If I were able to play, yeah, if I were able to play Steward and Captain both as terminal coins, I would be able to hit double province. I think we're going to leave the goat. Oh. So he has three caravans. That's pretty good. He's got three ironworks and one pixie. And one. Is he out of sacrifices? Yeah. So he only has three terminal actions he can play. But he doesn't have to play any captains, so that's two Sacred Groves and a Steward, I guess. But not a Terminal Ironworks. Okay. Does he have three ironworks? Yeah. But he'd have to gain and play ironworks to be able to end with a win. Wait, where did he get an extra action from? Oh yeah, what did the captains do? I didn't pay attention to that. Oh, he played a captain as a sacrifice, then one as a steward. Okay. The Flame's Gift. No thanks. Whoa, he actually took the Flame's Gift? That's weird. He's got a pixie left. I think. I can sacrifice a Will-O-Wisp. Yeah, that's an interesting play. I can't take that. Oh, he has an... Oh, God, I keep getting confused. His captain as steward. That's his actual steward. Okay. Okay. Puts me in a bit of a tough spot. Alright. What do we want to play this as? So that was his good turn. So this turn is going to be a little more awkward for him. Maybe I just go for double province. Might be the right play. In which case, I think I'm going to sacrifice the steward. No, I sacrifice the Will-O-Wisp, and then I can play three terminals. Is that accurate? I don't think that's accurate. Now, if I sacrifice the sacrifice, then I can definitely play three terminals. Yeah, I think that works. All right, I'll do that. Got a silver down there. Dang. Dang. I needed my province to be bottom decked, or I needed to get a plus card out of either Sacred Grove or Pixie. So I guess we're just getting province duchy. In which case, kind of wish I did take the Earth's gift. So I think we ironworks for a sacrifice here. Well, we could ironworks for an estate. For a silver or something. I guess I'll ironworks for a silver. It would be nice to draw this caravan, but we don't even have a guarantee. Oh wait, we can just... Oh no, we can't play the caravan then if we draw it. So might as well leave it on top, I guess. Yeah, I don't think there was a way there. Maybe there was. What if we had ironworks for a steward? Then drawn with the steward? No, I don't think that works. So maybe Marin can end it here. He's got two sacrifices, which is pretty good. And he can captain a sacrifice. I like to see him trash the ironworks, though. Yeah, that's pretty good. I mean, that's really good. Okay. So he's just going for points, which seems correct. Okay. Okay. Sure, I'll receive it. So he's out of pixies, he's out of caravans. Theoretically, he could have. He's got one captain left. Yep, there it is. Yeah, I mean, if he buys two provinces here, it's pretty game over for me. Oh, great. Yep, this sure looks over. All right, well, we can't lose any more. So I don't. Yeah. Think there's a ton of takeaways there. Like, the Ironworks sacrifice thing was kind of interesting, but also a little bit wheel spinning. I think it was mostly just player one and draws that gave Marin the advantage. He had like an opportunity to get the sacred gro the second sacred grove, which is big. All right, so we got goons here. Goons experiment. Quarry looks pretty great as a result. Trashing is difficult. There's mint and transmute. Always a favorite. So, but there's no plus actions, right? A single goons board. Definitely want at least one quarry. Maybe there's even a two quarry board. Probably not though, right? Because there's only you only have two buys. No, Seaway. So maybe we get Seaway on experiment and we just try to like dominate the experiment pile. Silver does not excite me here. Fortune teller is good, except that, I mean, the attack is good, but it doesn't help us get goons. Interferes with playing goon, whatever. Sorry, we're gonna buy goons. That's a good card. Gonna trigger a shuffle here. Alright, well, we're even. So I could mint here. A little bit awkward. Like going down to just two copper and a quarry. How do we build up from there? Still, we'll just play our goons so much more often. Wow, that was unlucky. That was extremely unlucky. That was a very good turn. Frustrated. All right, so we can do the same thing here. Laboratory experiment. I really want to get Seaway on experiment, but I'm not quite sure how to do that. This is a good opportunity for Marin to get Seaway on experiment. Let's see if he does it. Yep. Yep, that's pretty nasty. I might just be locked out of the game. Do I want to draw? Last card is a copper. Or a mint, isn't it? Yeah. So I have a 50% chance. Fifty percent chance of getting. Getting this copper, which we need to be able to Seaway. Can I possibly wait one more turn? Maybe. I'm just afraid he's gonna get like six or seven of the experiments. Could have bought two experiments there. No, that doesn't quite work. Yeah. Oh, that's excellent. No goons. Yeah, I mean, he hasn't trashed, so. Okay. I think we gotta do it though. Gotta get that Seaway. Oh, you know what we could do? We could just Seaway Laboratory. Seems pretty good. Still no goons. It's weird. That could just put us in a game-winning position. Have to think about how I build up, though. Do I have to get a silver? Wow. That's wild. Think I just get all the experiments here. Need to make sure there's not a big piles threat. Maybe I just get one more quarry and then I can end on piles. Maybe not though. It's a little tricky. Do we play two more? Yeah, we need to. That's my quarry. Just want to be super clear. He's got six spies. No way for him to end the game. You know, I should consider getting copper. So I'm gonna have seven buys. No, I don't like copper. Well, let's think about it. So I normally have five coins. I kind of want to be able to buy quarry and two experiments. So maybe I do get one copper. Then maybe I buy a bank. Big mint. The problem with that big mint is you're not going to have any money. It's a weird game. Okay, so he goes with the silver there. Sweet. All right, we can play one more experiment. Now let's go ahead and get ourselves a quarry and two experiments. And then next turn we can get a bank. We split the labs. It's nice, we don't have to draw those two cards. There's another funny thing. I'm actually now encouraged to play all my experiments because we get an extra point from goons. Yeah, buys are not an issue, so. Yeah, we have enough buys. And they're free. So, okay, so now we have 11 coins. That is enough to buy colony. We don't have to, but it's an option. Also enough to empty, yeah, but then we're gonna lose experience. The three pile is really difficult. Maybe we can do it with estates, with one more bank. Like if we buy bank estate next turn or something. We're gambling a little though. Well, no, that won't work either. How do we end this game? Do we do it one colony at a time? Uh-oh. Ruh-roh. Bank's a pretty good card. There's no way to get more buys, to my knowledge. So we have seven buys. I just don't see a pile out. Unless it's quarry. No, I just don't see it happening. So I think we just buy colony. Could buy one more bank. Definitely a little concerned. But, let's do it. Or should it be platinum? Platinum's better if we have a dud turn. It's a little more reliable. Yeah, let's do platinum. Can imagine a world where it makes sense to get Alchemist. Transmute was non-terminal, maybe it would see some play. Maybe. State to gold is pretty good. I don't know. Maybe it makes sense to get a Goons at some point. Not quite this point. It's a little scary. I wonder if I'm capable of triple province now. Not quite, I think. But we can build up to that point. Ta-da! Well, now we're going to find out exactly how much we have. And we do have enough. Sweet. Cash in our sinister plot. Let's say we go for it. Sure is buying cards. I don't know if we made it. Nope, not quite. Okay. One. Ooh, get donate. We are player two, which is a little unfortunate, but what do we have? I feel like building is almost certainly correct here, considering there is Duke. Although there's expand to help mill provinces. So you can't build forever. And there's a big problem with building, in that there's no plus actions. Okay. Oh, we have a 5-2. Is that good? All right, what are our options? We could turn one donate. Don't see a ton of value to that. I mean, it's pretty okay for like a wharf money thing. Yeah, if only there was plus actions, building would look so much more appealing. As it is, I'm thinking about turn one, donate. Now, does it make sense to wharf and then donate? Down to how many copper, though? Five, six. So if we do turn one, donate, we buy wharf on turn three. If we do turn two, donate. And then, like, wharf on turn three, other wharf on turn four, gold on turn five. So, if we do wharf first, then donate. Trouble is, our wharfs get, like, kind of out of whack. Because turn three, we play wharf and we're paying off debt. Turn four, it's a duration wharf. We don't want to buy wharf, so we buy gold, I guess. I like the turn one donate a little better. I haven't thought this all through. There's going to be another donate at some point. I don't think Guardian does anything for us. So 1 out of 6 were really sad. Wow. That's amazing. If only there were plus actions. As is, you can get the expand. Maybe you can do like a cobbler or two? Like, expand into cobbler, expand into cobbler. Expand into 4 for something, or forum. I don't know. This board needs plus action. We're just gonna kind of. Yeah, we're not gonna plan in advance when we do our. Yeah, I mean, that's really nice to be able to donate there with freaking 7 coins. Yeah, I mean, I'm almost certainly behind now. Like, he only needs to keep 2 copper, and he can buy a wharf next turn. So he's 1 turn behind me, but he has a much better set of treasures. He kept 3, though, which is interesting. Not sure why he kept that last copper. Oh, should go buy gold here, I guess? But the gold doesn't really help. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, the gold doesn't help if wharf is your intended terminal. And wharf should be your terminal because it's a great card and it gives plus buy. Yeah, I don't like that. So here I buy wharf and copper. Silver is next, or gold, then gold, silver. And then we start to consider another donate at some point. Alright, so you got a wharf there. Yeah, you need the wharf. You might not have drawn the wharf, though. No, don't do this to me. Dang it. I don't need this today. I really don't need this today. 1 out of 9 chance. I One out of nine. Of course. Why? See both wharves here. Why not? Why wouldn't I? This is unbelievable. Now we can buy Gold Wharf. He's just miles and miles ahead of me. That's frustrating. That's four copper there, that's pretty bad. So if we donate here, do we buy two silver? No, we can't do two silver donate. It's either silver donate or gold donate. So we actually only have four good treasures. That makes the donate pretty awkward. We're running out of time to donate, though. So if we buy gold, silver here. Actually, gold sinister plot isn't crazy. Yeah, let's do that. Okay, so we need to think about, like, we can always do Duchy Duke. Potentially to come back. Forums will get pretty good once we have green cards. Now, if he just goes for three duchies, that'll be interesting. Alright, I need good mentality here. Assuming I win here. How does that happen? Okay, so he's going for the duchies. Interesting. All my copper here, of course. Well, we're gonna build one more turn in terms of money. Then we're gonna. Every time. Can I not get terminal collision? And of course, he hasn't missed a wharf. And he's got a forum in his next three cards. So we won't miss a wharf next turn, but that's not our mentality. Our mentality is, how are we winning this game? It sure seems difficult to win contesting duchies, right? Let's think about that. But first of all, we should donate. Probably gold donate. Yeah. It only ever so slightly costs me this turn, the gold. Or like next turn. Assuming I draw it. Just one coin, then it helps in the future. That seems like the right thing to do. Two buys though. Still can be farmed, duchy duchy. He's got a sinister plot as well. I missed when that happened. Can I win on provinces? So dukes are going to be worth a ton. Let's look at what I have. So in general, I have 19. It's not a great number. Alright, so at the moment, if I take three duchies, then he's got 5-point dukes. And I've got 6-point provinces, and he's got a point lead heading into it. My deck is cleaner, of course, but he's got forums. If he manages to take the remaining duchies, he's got 8-point dukes that cost less than my provinces. Best case scenario here, it takes me 4 turns to empty provinces. And that's, is that possible? I'd have to get really lucky. Like, I've got the sinister plot, that helps me out on the last turn, but and next turn, I just need to bottom deck a province. No, it doesn't matter. Next turn, I have it guaranteed. So it's just the penultimate turn that actually I need to get lucky on. And I can buy a guardian on that penultimate turn. So maybe I can actually get 8 provinces in 4 turns here. That would be a lot of points. That's 48 points. To his 24 from duchies. And so how many dukes would he need? You need 3 dukes to match that. So, can he get 3 duchies and 3 dukes faster than I can get 6 provinces? Probably. But maybe that's my only chance. I feel like I lose if I contest on duchies at this point. Let's try it out. Oh, I would need to have bottom decked a province in order to be able to buy a guardian here, unfortunately. So that part of the plan didn't work. Oh, he didn't have a wharf in play. Interesting. Might have a chance here. I'm most worried about next turn. Think this should be a duke. Does have the sinister plot. So we'll have to see what the points are like. But that's a no-brainer. Now we're even on points. Oh boy. I really want to see my wharf. Can you do that for me? Yeah, I think I just needed to get luckier. Oh, okay. Doesn't get a guardian or an estate, okay. Ooh, all right, feeling good. Did we do it? Oh my goodness. Okay. Now he can draw a lot of cards with a sinister plot, right? He can draw three cards with a sinister plot, and he's got the wharf. He's got a lot of forums. But I feel like I lose the long game. And I guaranteed get two provinces next turn with that five card draw, so I think. Yeah, let's see what he has. So he's got the same number of golds and silvers as I do, I think. Or no, hold on. He has three golds to my five. He has three golds and two silvers. That's 13. How many coppers does he have? He has three. So he is threatening double province. Let's see if he can get there. So he draw five cards at the start of his turn. He has 10 left. He's got three forums. But does he have enough green cards to discard? He does. Yeah, so if he does get the three, Darn. Yeah, if he finds a forum, finds a forum, finds a forum, finds a wharf, he will be able to buy double province and win. And I'd say that's kind of likely. Maybe not. I don't think he can do it with two forums. Like, not reliably. He's gonna have just two cards on bottom. If, like, it's just any treasure he doesn't get. So if his bottom card is, like, forum copper or something. Or no, one his bottom four cards has a forum. And one of his bottom two cards is not green. Or is a treasure. Then that would be a win for me. Because he has to find basically three forums first. Alright, so I'm leaning towards two province. What are my other options? I can go forum duchy duchy. Now, even in points, but he's got an easier pile to claim. And I don't really have any good secondary points to get. Like, I kind of just have to get two provinces two turns in a row, and he just puts another card on Sinister Plot. And we know he definitely can't outscore two provinces, like, even if he gets three dukes. Oh, shoot. Three dukes might... Well, I should be able to get two provinces in a state. I think I want to get two provinces here. A tie is actually okay for me also. Forum two duchies or... Yeah, if I get forum two duchies, then what am I saying? I'm saying I want to get two provinces followed by two provinces. What does he need to beat that? He needs five dukes or like four dukes in an estate? Maybe that's the way to go. Man, this is tough. He's got two turns over which... If he gets five dukes, then that's certainly over for me. And I feel like he has actually an easier time getting three dukes and two provinces on his Sinister Plot turn. So it's a question of, can he get two dukes on his non-Sinister Plot turn? Man, I'm just doing it. Right, because the other thing is, if I get two provinces on the following turn, he still has the same opportunity to cash in Sinister Plot to get the last two provinces. We just don't want to see another forum. Dang it. Man, that's frustrating. That's brutal. That is brutal. All right, I'm gonna take a quick break. That was a long, long three games. Okay, I am back. I need to win the last three games to get to a tiebreaker. Horn of Plenty, but the only draw is Crossroads. Can this possibly work? Can we get enough uniques? 1, 2, 3, 4. 7, 8. It'd have to be all three of the basic treasures, I think. No. With the one terminal, we can get enough uniques. Barely. But boy, is it difficult to build. No, we can't do it. There's no extra plus actions, right? So we'd only be able to play three crossroads. This set looks less stressful. Okay. Yeah, so I don't think I believe. I think we just do Cathedral Spices money. Probably with Bard. Yeah. Oh, shoot, there's Ghost. Does that make a Horn Funny thing possible? Oh, gosh. No, this seems really stressful, Marin. I can't do it. I can't expend that much mental energy. How I feel about Ghost. Guess we'll just see. Could get a ghost here. I'd rather play the Bard. Um, Okay. I think a silver is worth one coffers. I think so. Not super confident about it, though. Makes sense. So each trashed our estates. I could have considered holding an estate, but there's plus buy, so. Do we want to relinquish our coffers? I don't think so. Let's bolster our coffers. This looks nice. Great. Okay. I think it's just a gold here. I think I want to start provincing on turn 9, it looks like. My gold misses the shuffle. That's fine though. Still get to keep my coffers. Sticking to my guns. So I don't have plus buy here, which is kind of annoying. We could get a ghost. I don't like it. Too much anti-tempo. Fortune teller, interesting. Okay. I see that. Looking good. Looking good. That's fine. Thinking about getting a crossroads. But, we'll wait. Guess we trash the Wisp. This looks like a pretty bad board to be player one. Yeah, he can take the province, like, next turn if he wants. Interesting. And we hope he gets, like, Fortune Teller Bard Collision. We shall see. I cannot offer a tie. That's something I'm not allowed to do. So that's pretty rough. What's he thinking about? Double Duchy or Province Crossroads? Cellar is about as good as Crossroads until you have multiple of them. Yeah, there's no way the Horn of Plenty thing is fast enough. Right? Heisen gains a copper. Interesting. Interesting. So we get Province Crossroads or Province Estate, I want to say. This will be the third province. Crossroads is unlikely to collide with two. I think we go Province Estate right now. Really just make it unattractive for him to get a province here. Looks like a bad turn for him anyway. I could go for two duchies here. Do I want to put a Crossroads in my deck, though? Could be like... Eh. Oh, we could also save the coffers if we get a cemetery. Let's grab two duchies. Oh, shoot, Bridger. Alright, let's think about this for a little bit. What do I want to trash here? Yikes. Yuck. We're just in a bad spot. Yeah, we're in a real bad spot. But that was a really good turn for him. hopefully he won't see more like those. Huh. That was a really good boon, but in general, I think fortune teller's better. Yeah, that's unfortunate. So, we just get a duchy here. Or we get a duchy estate after trashing the estate, which means we keep the silver. Yeah, that seems better. I think Forest Gift hasn't come up yet. Cemetery is a safe get. But I think he wants to get the duchy. Alright. I don't have plus buy in my hand. Could grab the ghost. I'm into it. Marin does absolutely nothing. I can win. Maybe. No, I can't. Sadly. He should probably buy spices, I think. It's a tough call. It's a tough call. Oh yeah, if he gained spices, he would have potentially lost there. Is copper any good? I don't think so. Maybe it is. Oh, great. Well, we're gonna trash that ghost. Oh, shoot. We did it. Okay. Still alive. Need to win the last two, and this one's going to be Marin's start. Wow. This looks like a bunch of junk. Oh boy, this game. Yikes. Yikes. I mean, we gotta open Sea Hag, right? Nothing to it. So he's got the 2/5. That seems pretty bad. Ooh, this seems nasty. Seems nasty. We do want to hit 8 at some point. Citadel's gonna be good. Crypt to start. Okay. Well, I'm really happy with the Den of Sin here. I'm not too happy about, oh, that was a really bad draw. But I mean, you opened it. You opened Crypt, so. So I have four coppers remaining. It's either gonna be Monument or Island. I think I'll try Island. This game is going to be long. Like, collision's going to be unfortunate. For sure. Yep, Sea Hag. Not what I want to see. I hope they don't collide. Maybe I just get a fortress. Yeah, Monument's pretty good here. There's just like, there's no control, so getting a fortress is kinda dumb. I think I just get another silver. Yeah, that's what I was afraid of. And our Den of Sin misses the shuffle. Buying coppers. Seems like we're gonna do that at some point. How do I feel about a monument? I guess I'll get one. It'll be good with Citadel. Every time they're gonna collide now. It's pretty guaranteed, I guess. Do I get a fortress? Almost no chance this does anything useful. Collide again. I think I get a silver here. We just want to win that split, I think. Ooh, can we get gold here? That'd be pretty good. We can. Nice. Citadel Island works, I think. Let's get another den. Crypt Crypt is okay, for sure. Yeah, if he gets a swamp bag. Ooh, but now I have an opportunity. Hopefully there's a curse left to give. Ooh. I have gotten very fortunate this game. Even though my island and Sea Hag have been glued together, could be worse. We're gonna get a monument now because we have Citadel. Be really sad. Oh, that's not optional. Whatever. There's plenty of stuff to set aside. Okay. And we could definitely get a province, but I think I want a gold. Definitely want to win that gold split. We are way ahead. Not so much on silver, so that's okay. Oh, did he buy a copper? If I ever have a bad turn, I'll do that. It's a nice crypt. Ooh. All right, so I don't think he's gonna win golds. I think we get a province. Yeah, it looks like the piles are going to be Cursed, Den of Sin, and Island. Just want to make sure we have the points lead as we head in that direction. Okay. Can Discard two cards from the top of his deck. I don't know. Maybe. Sure, let's do it. Maybe it ends on province. Stranger things have happened. Both set aside some bad cards with Island. I wonder if I should get an island here. I think so. No, I can believe that's incorrect. It just seems like three Den of Sins is a little overkill on a one by board. Yeah, let's get a province. That's annoying. I want a Den of Sin. Hopefully I draw two coins. Don't want him to get... Yeah, okay. This is looking like a win. Just need to win this last game to bring it to overtime. This is my start, I think, yeah. Okay. Into the last game. Got Torturer, Villa. Plenty of trashing. All right, this seems like an exciting one. Pretty fast. So we want to look for some remake Villa opportunities, I think. Yeah, I think I'd like a remake Border Guard opening. We don't get Torturer for a little while that way, but nice to be clean. I think we can find quite a lot of use for remake. Well, I'm not great with it, but it seems like we should be able to find some use for it. Because, like, you can delve for silvers, and you can remake silvers into Villa. And then you can remake a Villa into Torturer. Seems pretty good. Seems like a really good card. And I like Border Guard in the opening just to make sure that our remake does not miss. As first player, we do not want that to happen. As for what to trash, I don't know too much. Like, obviously, I want to be able to buy Border Guard or Delve, depending on the situation. But otherwise, like, getting some silvers from Remake seems pretty good. Okay. So here the question is, do we get a second Remake? I mentioned there being some pretty good Remake tricks. And Remake on Remake is pretty fine. I mean, it's good. The alternative is Delve Border Guard. Not super familiar with the double remake type approach. Let's just think this through a little. Like, the upside is we potentially get to trash on turns 5 and 6, and then they collide like on turn 7 and we get a torturer. Is that all too slow? Like, do we really need to get torturer earlier? I don't think so. And here we get two silvers and a border guard. Yeah, that makes me definitely not like the Delve border guard last turn. Okay. This could just be a torturer. If he goes for double remake or like Herald, there he does it. So mirror so far. Yeah, this is an obvious torture, right? Okay, now we have the option to remake our remake. Alternatively, I mean, yeah, it's not a complete mirror because I do have the extra silver at the cost of one more copper, but one fewer state. I mean, we're ahead. Okay. So we can get yet another torturer. Or we can keep two remakes. Get another border guard. I think I get a border guard regardless. So it's a matter of whether I want a torturer or a remake and one fewer copper. I think I want to start the pain as early as I can. Definitely a torturer. This is not expected. But we do have another torturer in those four cards, which is pretty good. What do we do with 10? We only have the one remake left, so something like Delve Torturer seems not great. Do I want the villa? I think I do want a villa. It's plus buy. Yeah, let's just do that. And then there's the question of, do we want a silver? There's just so much use for the silver, but are we getting ahead of ourselves? I can believe that. I can believe that. So he doesn't have a torturer yet. Okay. I think we want to trash these coppers more than anything else. That is setting our hand up to be not great. Yeah, how much have we discarded? A lot of things we haven't shuffled. Yeah, I think we'll just leave it here. Get a herald. Three torturers might be enough. I wouldn't mind a fourth. I think I want to buy one more villa. So we've discarded some cards. Just two, right? So we can actually draw everything? Seemed like it. Potentially we just remake this villa right now. Yeah, that looks pretty good. Then buy two heralds. Now I have some overdraw. And we can hopefully take advantage of that. We gotta watch piles. We have got to watch piles. He does have two torturers. Okay, he's not playing them. Oh, maybe he is. I think. I think I'll discard here. I want to give him the curses, if at all possible. On the other hand, I need to make sure I have enough to buy a villa. Yeah, that seems likely enough. Still has two remakes. He just didn't play them. Or use them in any way. Oh, he only has one curse in his hand. So what else is in his hand? A border guard? Border guard, curse, remake. Gotta watch piles. We should be able to give out all these curses. Faithful Hound. Okay. Oh, what if I hit remake? That would be a tragedy. Eh, not a complete tragedy. All right, well, I guess we're gonna get some villas. Darn. Probably a villa in a remake, actually. So what can we hit with Harold? Think we might have one more Harold in there, and I think we have one more villa. Dang. Not great. So what do we have here? Can we delve torturer or something? Or delve villa? No, we can only single delve villa. Darn. These darn heralds hitting remakes. Ruining all my plans. I'm also a little scared to bring the villa pile down. So if I do buy like Delve Copper Villa, what is that last card? It's a border village, right? Well, or a border guard? I'm happy to have a border guard on top. So I'll just leave it there. Everybody's gonna hate me for this, but I think I'm gonna buy a gold. It's worth 3 points. And I kinda need payload. that immediately. Interesting. He's got three silvers, I think, so two in his hand. Yeah, these heralds are a little bit awkward. Need to think about some fancy remake tricks. Probably want to remake, like, Curse and, and maybe Villa or Herald into Sacred Grove. And then, like, buy Sacred Grove and Villa, and then play the Sacred Grove and things and stuff. Could be pretty good. No thanks. Gold is good, but yeah, he's got more payload than I do. And having no difficulty drawing his deck. It's a little bit concerning. Okay, I wonder if I can win. We can't trash our silver. We otherwise need to get three villas and three border guards. In terms of setting up my heralds, I'm actually a little bit concerned about taking Lantern, maybe. I think sifting two is enough. And I'm actually going to play Villa Torturer first. Well, that is unfortunate. So if I draw the remake, or if I play a remake with Herald, I think I can trash one Herald. right. So what is left? What are those remaining three cards? I think I have one Herald, one Villa, and one Torturer. Okay. So I am out of heralds. We've otherwise got plenty of draw. We don't actually need to trash that curse. So if we wanted to trash Remake and Torturer to get Sacred Grove. And gold. We could trivially draw that. So that would give us an extra six coins. What is that top card? That's a copper, I think. Maybe it's not. Hold on. Wait, when did I shuffle the deck? Yeah, okay. Yeah, that's a copper. So I have 6, 9, 10 coins right now if I count the villa. I'm talking about going up to 16. And I need 16. So I think this works. And even if I get Wind's Gift, Border Guard can pull it up. The only way. No, if Earth's Gift, then I just mirror with Gaining Island. That'll work fine. Okay. So we managed to get the 4-2 outcome. That was nerve-wracking. I think there was going to be a tiebreaker, and if so, that'll probably be the next content I upload. Until then, go USA!